Hello, fellow collectors and diecast enthusiasts. What is good? Well, I can tell you what's good here at DNC Diecast today. Today we have an M2 haul. Yes, my friends, M2. We're going to take a look at some M2s that came courtesy of a collection that I recently purchased and take a look at some of my recent pickups in the store from M2. Should be a good video, so sit back and let's take a look and see what all M2 has to offer. Alright guys, welcome in. Let's get it started with the 69 Dodge Charger Daytona Hemi. Awesome card art. What do you think? I guess that's the demon. And here it is. Here is your model. 69 Dodge Charger Daytona Hemi. How cool is that? Awesome, huh? There's the top. Looking good. I love the big wing. I don't know why, but I love it. And there's the front. And does that look cool? But this car used to fly around the track. I'm gonna actually see some of the videos of one of these Hemis flying around the track. How cool is that? This is an awesome casting. I don't normally go for this casting, but I think this particular casting in this particular color with this particular deco looks absolutely amazing. What do you think? Do you like it? Did you find it? Let me know in the comments. Cool. Good stuff here. And next we have, it looks like, the 1967 Chevrolet Camaro SSRS 396 in RHS. Racing head service. All right. Look at those rims, huh? Wow. Does that look sharp? I don't think that you could possibly look any sharper on a Camaro than that. Wow. There's the top. Here's the front. Look at that grill. SS moniker right up front. Awesome. Yep. There's the card art. Racing head service. Oop, let me move my finger out of the way. There we go. What do you think, guys? Do you ever have too many 67 Camaros in your collection? I say no. And do you ever have too many M2 67 Camaros in your collection? I say absolutely not. Can't get over how awesome those rims are. Wow, does that look nice. What do you think? Let me know in the comments. Cool. And next up we have a 1968 Chevy Camaro Z28 with Chevrolet Sports Department deco. There's the card art. Oh, pardon me. There's the card art. And here is our model. Now see, you see those rims? I don't dig those rims too much. I'd love to see the other rims on this car too. But, you know, you can't always get what you want. Check that out. Love the racing stripe. I don't know if that's forest green or whatever kind of green it is, but we'll just call it green. How cool is that? Nice. Nice. Did you guys find this when it was out on the pegs? Or did you pass on it? Let me know in the comments. Either way, this is pretty cool. If you're a fan of American Muscle, I think this is a must-have for your collection. Awesome. Nice. And next we have a 1967 Chevrolet Camaro SSRS 396. Well, we're going right through the 60s with these Camaros. Pretty cool. There's your card art. Holly. Now, I don't know much about cars, but I guess that's an engine of some sort, obviously. What part of the engine, I don't know. But if you want to read the card art, freeze your screen and you can read away. Nice. Then we just built the 9-second carburetor. So whatever that is, I'm sure it's awesome. And here is your car. Wow. Does that look nice? Those rims look great too. Really cool. Looks good in white. And there's your front. Holly on the hood. Yep. Wow. It's even got a deco on the roof. What's that say? Holly. Of course. What else would it say? What do you think, guys? I think this is pretty nice. Let me know what your thoughts are on this in the comments. Nice. Very nice indeed. And next up, this is a very Camaro-centric video all of a sudden. The 1970 Chevy Camaro Z28 RS, looking good in pink. There's your card art, which is basically just the bow tie. And here is your casting. Wow. I'll tell you what, very few cars look bad in pink, and this car does not look bad at all. Looks very nice, especially if you're a fan of the 1970 Chevy Camaros. And to be quite honest, I would ask, who isn't? That's almost like saying you don't like bacon. Look at that. And I bet you were styling in 1970 if you were cruising around town in this. No problem picking up girls, for sure. Awesome. Almost looks like a pace car for the Indy 500 or something. But still, very cool. Did you find this, or did the scalpers beat you to it? Let me know in the comments. Very nice indeed. And next we have one of my personal favorites from last year. This came out. This is the 1969 Plymouth Roadrunner 440 5-pack. Looking good in black. Wow, that's nice. That is nice. What do you guys think? Look at that detail. Wow. You really get your money's worth with an M2. No doubt. Plenty of rare detail. How cool is that? Nothing on top, as there should not be. And look at that card art, huh? Wow. Smacks of the 1970s. And here we are. Well, actually, I guess it's a snacks of the 1960s. And 1969 being the last year of the 60s, why not? Let it all hang out. Cool. Nice looking ride. And next we have the 1971 Chevy Camaro SS396 with Haze Deco. Check out that card art, huh? Clutches and disc haze. Awesome. Look at that, huh? I like those rims. Those rims look really nice. There's your front. There's your side. And there is the rear, complete with the 1971 license plate and haze on the back window. Cool. And that racing stripe looks good too. You don't normally see them on one side of the car like that, on the left-hand side drive racing stripe. I don't know if that's something that is unique to the 70s, but it's just not something you see very often anymore unless you get a custom paint job. How cool is that though, huh? Nice. Would you guys find this on the pegs? And if you did you buy it or did you pass on it? Let me know, of course, in the comments. Awesome. And this is a recent pickup. This is Edelbrock equipped Chrysler Plymouth Dodge, 1957 Chrysler 300G. Man, I bet you were styling in 1957 if you were riding around in this baby. Around the track or cruising around town. Either way, nice. This is what American Muscle was all about in the 1950s. Look at that grill. Wow. That has got some bite to it. Yep. And there is the decos on top. Nice. I don't know whose name that is. Is that Vic Edelbrock? I don't know. Something. I think it's Vic. I don't know. If you know, let me know in the comments. My glasses just aren't. Well, number one, I don't have them. And I can't really see it that good. And there is your 1957 license plate. Your big wings on the back. And of course, Edelbrock equipped on the trunk. That's pretty cool. That's different. Wow. Nice. What do you think? This has actually been kind of the peg warmer in my area. There's still one hanging on the pegs right now as we speak. I couldn't resist it. As soon as I saw it, I was like, whoa, man, we've got to add this to the collection. Nice. Let me know what your thoughts are in the comments. And this was also a recent pickup. This is the 1968 Pontiac Firebird 400 HO. Not sure what the HO stands for, but whatever. There's the card art, and there is your model. Wow, does that look nice. That purple has a little sparkle to it. Interesting. Interesting. Ooh, that front looks good. Nice blown motor. Nice. And here is the rear. Wow, how cool is that? Again, if you are a fan of American Muscle, This is a must-have for your collection. Card art is absolutely spectacular. Look at that. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Nice. Now, these are definitely some more recent pickups that I found at Walmart, or as I like to say, Fraud Mart, but that's another conversation for another day, so we'll leave Walmart alone for now. And this is the 1988 Ford Mustang GT with Racing Deco. What do you think? I think it looks pretty nice. I think it looks pretty nice indeed. There's your front. There's your side. And look at all that detail in the rear. How cool is that? Nice. And the Ford symbol in the card art. Nice. All right. Nice. Little detail on the roof, a racing stripe and a cast line. I think that's what it says. I don't know. If you can read it, let me know in the comments. Yep, cast line. I'm sure that's what it is. Ford Performance. Not fix often, repair daily, but Ford Performance. Nice. Awesome. Two of those. All right. This was a gift from Diecast Diane. She seemed to be very high on this. I probably would have passed on it personally, but since she gave it to me, we will take a closer look at it. This is the 1949 Studebaker 2B truck. So the 2B tow truck, no doubt. All right. That's not bad. That's pretty cool. I actually like those rims. All right. There's the front. There's the side. There's a better look at the hauling apparatus. And here is the rear. Don't see a lot of rear detail on this one. I do not. But I guess you don't get rear detail on a tow truck. I don't know. But still, I love the Studebaker card art. That's cool. Where has Studebaker gone and who bought them and how long have they been out of business? If you know, let me know in the comments. The 1949 Studebaker 2B truck. Cool. Now this, when I saw this, I couldn't believe it was still sitting on the pegs. A lot of other things were gone, but there this was, and I was in shock that nobody picked it up. The 1968 Chevy Camaro SS350. How cool is that? We have got to open this up in a future video and take a closer look at it. Wow. I even like that red interior, and I never like a red interior. But the red interior actually works on this car, except for that oversized steering wheel. But you know what? We won't be too hard on M2. You can't be awesome everywhere, I guess. There is the front. There's the side. Plenty of rear detail. And look at how fat those rear tires are. Wow. Those are fat. And there is your top. Ooh, is that dusty? Pull out our dust rag. There we go. A lot better. Nice. Well, what do you think? 1968 Chevy Camaro SS350. Looking good. All right. Looks like we have two of those. Two is always better than one, as in most things in life. And next we have, looks like the Ford Econoline camper van. I don't normally go for these, but I think this looks pretty good. I like the Maui deco. Nice. What do you think? What do you think? Have you ever seen one in real life? I know I never have. All right. Spare tire in the front. Like all the front detail. Looks good. I don't know. I just can't imagine this is a real life camper, but evidently it was. All right. There's your rear detail. All right. 1965. It's a little Maui deco on the back door. I don't know. What do you think? What do you think? I think it looks all right. Nice. And bringing up the rear, we have, you know, and I wish I'd saved this for a longer video on my Dodge A100 panel van collections, but we'll bring this back out when that time comes. So wipe off the top a little bit here. There we go. And there we have the 1964 Dodge A100 panel van with Pan Am deco. Have any of you ever flown on Pan Am Airways? I never did, but I heard it was quite the experience. You were around when Pan Am was around? I'm sure you were living large if you were flying Pan Am. I don't know. You let me know in the comments if you flew Pan Am. There's the front. There's the side. And there is your rear, again, with plenty of detail. And once again, I will say, you really do get your money's worth with M2 in terms of detail. I'd love to do a wheel swap on one of these one of these days. Not exactly this particular model, but a wheel swap on one of the Camaros or something and see what it's got for the track. We'll see. That'd be a first. I've never seen any modified M2 racing, but there's got to be a first for everything, right? All right. Well, guys, that is it for the video. Which one was your favorite? Was it this one? Or maybe the Demon? Or maybe the pink Camaro? Who knows? Or maybe even the 57 Chrysler? I don't know. Or maybe it was this one, the 67 Camaro SSRS 396. You let me know in the comments which one was your favorite. And as always, thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. And wherever you are in the world, have a wonderful day. Until the next time.